Here at Corsair, we always focus on having the best support for new and upcoming platforms. And we recently had a chance to fly out to AMD's headquarters to speak with Chris Morley about the new Ryzen 3000 series and Radeon 5700 XT.
Hi, I'm Chris Morley, Technical Marketing at AMD. And I'm here with one of our valued partners, Corsair. This is Kevin Galloway.
Hi, guys.
And we're here to tell you a little bit about this system you see before you. If you've been paying attention at all, you know that we've launched some pretty cool stuff recently.
Yeah, we've been waiting for it. The Corsair gamers, streamers, we've all been waiting for it. And we're really happy to partner with you to do this build.
Well, we're happy to have you here. So this system has a Ryzen 9 3900X. It's a 12-core, 24-thread processor. We have our latest 7-nanometer Radeon 5700 XT graphics card, and that kind of forms the basis of this gaming, streaming, kind of ultimate PC. And then we've got a whole bunch of Corsair technology Kevin's going to tell you about.
So we have a whole slew of items in this build for you to support the new Ryzen 9 3900X and the 5700X XT. We have the MP600 NVMe M.2 SSD. Essentially, with the X570 chipset and PCIe Gen 4, you can get sequential read speeds up to 4,950 megabytes per second, and sequential write up to 4,250 megabytes per second.
That's
crazy.
So it's how much faster is that than PCI Express 3.0?
Oh, it's like 40% faster. Yeah. So yeah, I mean, you're looking at this huge leap in speed from PCIe Gen 3. With these devices.
And so we were first to market with the chipset that supports it. Mm-hmm. You guys were right there at launch with the drive to match.
I mean, it's exactly. It was nice cohesion.
And so it's not just AMD and Corsair technology that's in here. There's kind of an unsung hero inside that we haven't talked about from a little company called Asus. And it's the Crosshair 8 Hero Wi-Fi version. And that's what we're plugging everything into, the CPU, the memory, the SSD, the GPU. Everything goes in there. It's a great product. It looks great.
My favorite feature has to be the integrated I/O shield.
Oh yeah.
You know, so.
Whoever did that deserves a Nobel Peace Prize, or at least a raise. So besides all this great new CPU, GPU, and storage technology, we still have a bunch of stuff to talk about. What else is in here?
We are using our Dominator Platinum RGB. And we're using it at 3600 megahertz.
Which is the sweet spot that we've found in terms of maximizing the performance of Ryzen 3000 series. You're able to keep that 1-to-1 Infinity Fabric ratio.
And with the Ryzen 3000 series, we know that it can support much higher speed RAM, so.
Yeah, you can kind of get crazy with some of that overclocked RAM out there if you want to have some fun. In order to keep all of that stuff operating at maximum performance, we got to make sure that we're keeping it cool. So how are we doing that with this system?
In the system, we use the H100i Platinum series. It uses two 120 millimeter ML RGB Pro fans.
And those are tuned for all the radiators, right? And these aren't normal fans.
Exactly. So they have very good static pressure. So they can push all that air through the radiator with no problem.
This is an all-in-one cooler, so there's no maintenance. You just kind of bolt it in, right?
Exactly. And that's one of the major benefits of having an all-in-one is that it's so easy to install. You get really good cooling performance. And with the Platinum series, it's a step up over our Pro series because you have higher performance. You get the aesthetically pleasing multi-zone RGB in the pump head. And you also have the ML RGB Pro. So,
And so those fans, they come with the unit, you don't have to buy them separately, and they're specifically tuned for all-in-one cooling for the radiators, right?
Exactly, and everything's just all-inclusive. It just plugs into the pump head through the pigtails there, and you're good to go.
So we've got the CPU covered, cooled,
yeah,
and the power supply is what feeds all of it,
right.
And so that's also a Corsair product. Tell us a little bit about that.
So power supply is super important. A lot of people kind of skip over that a little bit. They're like, oh, I just need power for it. But really, it's important to have clean power delivered to all your components to make them last longer. So in this build, we use the AX1000, which is an 80-plus titanium, a super high efficiency PSU.
That means 80-plus means that if your system needs, let's say, 500 watts of power, it's actually going to pull more from the wall. But the more efficient it is, the less it's actually pulling from the wall. And if you're throwing a bunch of components in there, that can save you money in the long time.
So this one, 80 plus titanium, it has to meet a minimum of 94% efficiency.
That's crazy.
So that means whatever's pulling from the wall, it's actually outputting up to 94% of what it's drawing from the wall. So this one's great because it is fully modular cabling.
Nice.
And you're only using exactly what you need. And also this one uses zero RPM mode. So that means, under a certain load, it's not going to spin that fan, but then once it reaches that threshold, the fan will come on, so.
That's really cool. Yeah. And so even if you did have a power supply that wasn't modular, one of the cool things about the chassis that we're using here is that it's a kind of a dual chamber. And so the power supply is on one side, while all the components you see are on the other. and it makes for a lot easier when it comes to cable management.
So this is our Crystal Series 680X case, and like you mentioned, it's a dual chamber case. So you can hide all your cables, or most of the cables, I should say, your PSU, SSDs, and stuff in the back, while keeping all the cool stuff in front for everyone to view. And if you look here, you can see that there's very minimal cables coming out through the back. So
how's your cable management skills?
I'd say they're pretty good, but sometimes I can be a little lazy.
I'm so over it. I spent 15 years designing and building systems for other people. When I build one for myself, I don't like spending time on cable management. So being able to just cheat and throw them all back there and hide them is what I love. And of course, you're not impeding any airflow that's necessary for the components on the other side.
The 680X is a very popular case. It comes with a lot of features, dual chamber design being one of the main features of it, but it does come with a Lighting Node Pro, which is an LED controller, three LL120 fans.
And what is LL?
It means light loop. Okay. So basically, you have the outer ring, and then you have the hub-mounted LEDs. That way, it gives you kind of that dual zone.
Right, like what we've got right here.
Yeah,
you know?
Exactly.
And it's funny because you guys turned this on, and it had kind of its default pattern, and I go to get a glass of water. I come back a few seconds later, and you have this really cool Ryzen and Radeon color scheme, and it's not just the chassis fans, but it's the fans on the all-in-one cooler, the pump, the RAM sticks, the keyboard, mouse, and mouse pad all synced up.
Basically, we have our software IQ, and you're able to really quickly and easily create these profiles. You know, so within a couple minutes, like you said, when you stepped away, I was able to create this Ryzen-inspired setup. So,
and it's really cool. And so when you kind of put all this stuff together, and each of these parts individually are really cool, but when you put them all together, it delivers a fantastic experience for whatever you're going to do with it.
Right.
So if you're a AAA gamer, it gives you great frame rates and incredible visual fidelity at 1440p, which is one of the most popular resolutions for those types of games. If you're an esports gamer, 1080p, really high frame rates for those, you know, really Twitch games.
Right.
And there's really nothing it can't do.
With the performance increases that we've seen with the CPU, GPU, chipset, and storage and stuff like that, it really blurs the line between workstation and gaming rigs. So
absolutely. And actually, I'd argue that it erases the line, because it doesn't matter if you're a creative professional, a gamer, a streamer, or you just want the latest and greatest and some of the fastest computing technology out there, this system delivers a no-compromise experience. So that's why we want to have you out here. Big shout out to our friends at ASUS for the motherboard. For those of you watching, if you haven't built a PC in a while, it's a really great time to upgrade.
Between all the awesome Corsair components and AMD's latest CPU and GPU, this system is sure to make any gamer or content creator happy. Special thanks again to AMD and Chris Morley for showing us their latest and greatest hardware. For more information on the Ryzen or Radeon products, visit AMD.com. And for more information on our products, visit Corsair.com. Thanks for watching.